I feel very much like I can't really tell a huge difference between myself and Bella anymore, as odd as that sounds. I'm used to playing like really distinct characters that are so far away from my normal reality. And in this case, like the only thing that I was really worried about was just making sure that it was absolutely honest and open and vulnerable and very present. We're both pretty like instinctual, impulsive actors. We don't really like, you know, hash things over and over because we both know our characters fairly well. It was easy to like step back into the project. It was something we did. Once you play someone, it's a strange thing. You just don't forget who they are. And we worked together well, so it was easy. Edward and Jacob offer entirely different, like there's every human being in the world has a void, because you can't live life by yourself. You can't be alone. And for whatever reason, Bella is like instinctually in need. I mean, can't live without Edward. And so if I had something like that, then that would definitely be what I went for, because it wouldn't be a choice. But the odd thing about the story is that it's a smarter thing. It's a more, I mean, objectively from the outside, she should be with Jacob. She's best friends with him. He's warm. It's easy. There's no problems there, but you can't always take the easy way. On Bella's birthday, she's becoming more and more aware of her own age and mortality, and it's weighing on her very heavily. So she's not too excited to go to her birthday, where everything actually begins to. It's the catalyst for her breakup and like her like biggest nightmare, which is Edward leaving her. She cuts her finger, and nobody can handle being around her. And she has a near-death experience that sends Edward into like manic depression and self-hatred. And he saves her by breaking up with her, but really he's just making things more difficult than need be. Jacob's sort of the kid that you've known your whole life and always, you know, had an affection for and always been very close with, but not really taken a good look at him. He grows up overnight right in front of her in a time where she actually desperately needs a void to be filled. And the really bittersweet, awful thing is that he can't even begin to fill the void, but he can sort of help her forget that she has it. And he's just a very warm and, it goes beyond compassionate. He's so in love with her, but not in a greedy way, in a way that he will just lay it on the line for her, literally, in regards to anything. He's stepped up in a way that I think is like the most, I mean, out of anybody in this movie that has anything to do with this movie, it's like the most impressive sort of like transformation, which is funny because he's supposed to undergo a transformation in the movie anyway. But he did it in his real life, and it's so cool to see that and to be a part of it a little bit too. I mean, just to be around it. He's growing into a really good guy, and he's really good in the movie. He's so strong. Bella, in the beginning of the story, senses that her world is sort of falling apart, and at that point, for no reason. It's not like Edward is acting strangely. It's just she has a feeling, just like anyone before a big breakup. It's sort of like, you know, before it happens, that it's falling apart. And once it does, she sinks literally into herself to the point, you know, she ceases to function, and Jake pulls her out of that. We're all very thankful to have the massively enthused fan base that we have. It's like the ultimate driving force, and we all feel like we're a part of that fan base, and so, you know, thank you.